Multiple sclerosis impacts the lives of millions of people across the world. MS affects about 400,000 people in the United States. 10,000 new cases are diagnosed every year. Symptoms for MS usually appear between the ages of 20 and 40. MS is most commonly found in Caucasian women. But there is hope.
My name is Steve Miller. I'm a professor of microbiology and immunology at Feinberg School of Medicine at Northwestern University. And my laboratory for many years has studied how autoimmune disease is induced, progresses, but more importantly, we are attempting to develop treatments. Multiple sclerosis is an autoimmune disease in which particular kinds of white blood cells called T lymphocytes infiltrate the central nervous system, the brain and spinal cord.
The central nervous system consists of neurons, or nerve cells, which are sheathed in a fatty substance called myelin, which helps transmit impulses between the brain and the body and within the brain itself.
And myelin destruction is the hallmark of multiple sclerosis. So the advantage of our platform is that a nanoparticle carrier can be loaded with varying different antigens and theoretically has the opportunity to treat any different autoimmune disease that one can imagine as long as we know the antigenic target of that disease.
An antigen helps produce antibodies that fight disease within the immune system.
What we're attempting to do with the therapy is to administer the autoantigens, the myelin antigens, that are the target of the immune response in an MS patient in the central nervous system, in his brain and spinal cord. And our attempt is to administer these antigens so that we actually shut off the immune response rather than triggering it. For instance, if a patient is allergic to peanuts, the patient eats peanuts and undergoes an anaphylactic response that can be life-threatening. Again, in animal models, if we load peanut antigens into the nanoparticles and administer it, we could actually stop that disease and actually shut down the immune response to the peanut antigens. So the way that we attempt to shut the disease off is we can take myelin antigens, inject those particles intravenously into the bloodstream of the patients. We can both prevent disease from happening in the first place, but more importantly, we can cure a disease that's already been initiated. So at this point in time, we've gathered a lot of what is called preclinical data suggesting that this therapy is useful and has a robust effect in stopping disease progression. We have the opportunity with a collaboration with Dr. Dusan Stefalski and Rumen Balabanov from Rush University Medical School to actually carry out a phase one clinical trial in MS patients using our newly developed therapy.
While most therapies have focused on treating the symptoms of disease, Dr. Miller's platform is focused on preventing and curing the source of multiple sclerosis and other autoimmune diseases by specifically inactivating immune cells causing the disease.
We estimate that we might be able to get into a clinical trial in humans somewhere between a year and a year and a half from now.
This is Mark Rosenblum, Rosie, of the Rosie's MS Foundation. I was diagnosed with MS in 1985 and have been trying to find a cure ever since. Dr. Miller and his researchers are as close to finding that cure as I can hope for. Please help fund this research so that hundreds of thousands of people like me can benefit.